Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Painkiller. It's brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. Today, we are doing Catacombs. And as per usual, we're just jumping right in here. And so apparently the crashing issues are a known thing, which doesn't surprise me. Truth be told, we are going to start again. And you can see here that the frame rate is much better. I did some settings tweaks, and hopefully this will persist. And let's see, what is it? I think... There. That will cap us at 60 frames a second. Apparently, if your frame rate goes too high, that can cause the game to crash, and there's save corruption and all kinds of other fun stuff. So yeah, this Let's Play is gonna be one of those, apparently. Realistically though, since the game is kind of stage-based and the checkpoints are what I would consider to be fairly close to one another, I'm not worried about getting through this one. Truth be told. No, we missed one. Where is he? Is that everybody? Yeah, there we go. All right, I just want my state gun back. That's all that matters to me. But yes, this music definitely hits Quake. I don't know why specifically. There's just something about that guitar riff in there. That is very Quake-like. But I do think, starting with this episode, that I'm probably gonna try for an episode per stage. I think that's reasonable. There will probably be some shorter episodes. But that's just gonna be the way of things. The exception will probably be the boss stages. For the boss stages, I'll probably do, like, the boss stage and then the level after it, because of how the boss fights are handled in this game. Okay. Yeah, what I wanna do, yeah, like, this bridge last time was, like, completely glitched out and it wasn't even here and stuff. Yeah, I don't know what the, issue was. There you go, that's kind of showcasing that you can stake people to walls in this. Which would probably be more sufficient, I shouldn't say more sufficient, more entertaining in general if the corpses persisted a little longer than they do. Come on now. There we go. I missed him. There we are. Alright, is that everybody? That's everybody. Alright, so we have an option. I'm gonna hit the checkpoint. I'm gonna quick save. And we're gonna check out this room. Oh, I wonder if it's a trap. Is it a trap? I love it. It's hell limited. This is great. Oh, I hear critters, but I don't see nothing. Oh no! Several skeleton dudes. Whatever will I do? Yup. Okay. Grab this. God, I love the physics on this so much. This state gun is just great. Oh, hey there, buddy. Sorry, I was admiring the destruction. Oh yeah, these dudes, they combine into like a super dude if you get them too close to one another. Oh hey. Not a problem. Do I have any freezing shells? I do not. I shouldn't waste stakes on these guys. There we go. So now we can just go through there, or we can explore. This game doesn't have a lot of like just random exploring portions to it, but there's a little. Okay. Don't see anything else too interesting in here. Alright. Back for the entrance. Oh, where are they coming at me from? Oh shit! Nice try. Ah, fuck! Ah, damn it. And those dudes do some damage. Alright, let's see what we got. Shield dudes, is that it? Looks like it. Not impervious to the stake. Ah! A butt. Oh, my aim is just hot trash. It's okay. I managed to survive. Yeah, I mean, like, you can see here that they're giving us, like, a checkpoint after every, essentially every fight that we get through, so it's like, with the save game, ooh, that's, grenades. With the save game crashing, it's apparently, like, a save game corruption issue. Even with that, like, we're still not, like, exactly losing a ton of progress. Ugh, he tried. I say, gotta make sure nothing's sneaking up behind me. And naturally, you got stuff sneaking up behind me. Aw, this is getting a little, this is getting a little close quarters for my liking. Aw, shit. No, get off. Oh my God. Ah. I will say that thus far, this game has proven more challenging than Doom the Lost Mission on its equivalent difficulty. But I guess that's not really saying much. Alright, so there's one thing. Where is it? Where does it lurk? Crap, out of stakes. I'm not used to running out of ammo. Terrible. 0 out of 10. No game of the year for you. But no, seriously, this is a good game, and if you like fast-paced shooters, totally recommend it. You can deal with the bugginess. So fun fact, when I originally bought this game, this was during the days of, you know, CD keys being kind of like the main form of DRM. I bought it and there was no CD key in the box. The box hadn't been tampered with or anything. It just didn't ship with a box. And so I emailed People Can Fly or THQ. I can't remember. I emailed one of them about it and they asked me, you know, well, we need proof of purchase and we need photocopies of the CDs that the game ships on. So I got all that stuff to him, and then I never heard back from him. And so after that, I kind of swore off ever buying a THQ Nordic game ever again, and to this day, I have not. So, yeah. Fun stories. I don't even know if THQ Nordic is still around. I don't think they are they? I don't remember. He's a shaking. Oh, this is gonna be bad. Thankfully, I have a lot of room to maneuver. Whoa! Hey there, guys. Alright. See, this is why, like, the shotgun is a bad first weapon, because it's, like, not accurate at all. And like, you want like your basic weapon to be something that's like accurate and reliable, and the shotgun in this is not. Also, its damage is kind of crap. Just kind of a poor weapon. And once we get like a better arsenal under our belts, I will essentially not be using the shotgun unless it is the last thing that I have ammo for. Because it's just kind of a crummy gun. I think there's also like a rocket launcher. I seem to remember there being like a rocket launcher-esque weapon. I can't remember what it is though. Oh, sorry, buddy. I didn't intentionally just drill you in the junk with a spike. It just happened that way. Oh, shit. I have so much armor, but no health. Excuse me. Aw, oh, man. That's some trash tier aim on my part right there. Oh, messy. Nasty. Grenades, you're terrible. Your splash damage is just for naught. I can't hold still. All right. How many more of you D-bags are coming at me from back here? Jesus. Is that everybody? No. Is that everybody? According to compass, yet. Oh my god. Jesus. Oh, for fuck's sake. There we go. Alright. And now that I think of it, I don't think I've ever actually. Woo! I don't think I've ever beaten this on this difficulty. Normally I play it on. Just whatever the normal difficulty is. Did that thing even kill anybody? These grenades are terrible! Like, these grenades are just. Oh my god, where are all you guys coming from? There, I'm on the ground floor now. What are you gonna do about it? Okay, I think there's just that one dude left. Who's, you know, slowly working his way down to me. He'll get here eventually. I hope. There we go. Yup. All right. Got 14 hit points left, guys. Excuse me. I still cannot, for the life of me, get over this goddamn cough, and it is driving me insane. Oh, hey. Chill out. Chill out. No, really, dude. Chill out. Chill out. No. All right. I tried. If I recall correctly, in this one, you have to jump into this hell pit in this room. He's very intimidating. But with his shambling gait and generally constipated demeanor. And shed load of hit points. Can't tell if I'm hurting him. Is there a gimmick to killing you, sir? Do I have to, like, get you to drop into the hell pit? Dude. Come on, dude. Give it up. And shoot your little dangly hands. I'll wait. I was like, all right, maybe I need to get him under the edge there and then shoot it and collapse it, but no. Oh shit! Why would I do that? Esports! That was stupid. Let's try this again, shall we? Alright. Back down the hole. Alright, dude, what's your bag? Fuck. Oh, I'm terrible! I'm terrible, you guys! Even a basic jump is apparently behind my abilities at this. I can't even say it's a late hour, it's only like 1 in the morning. Jesus Christ. Come on, I do think I have to get him like on here or something. Cause like, I think I'm hurting him. Like when I shoot him, I don't know, maybe I just need to shoot him a lot. But I have to trim his hands. Now they just kind of flail around a little bit. He's just trying to say hello. Is he... No, he doesn't stagger back when I shoot him or anything. You guys. Let's see what happens if he just, if I just stand over here and wait. What are you gonna do, buddy? You're gonna punt me into the fire. All right. I probably should have seen that coming. Oh, I'm sure people are just gonna be raging in the comments about this. It's gonna be great. So what happens if I just stand down here? Curiosity has gotten the better of me. Thank you. Oh, now I've done it again. All right, well, against my better judgment, I'm gonna Google it. Cause this might be bugged. Let's see, what is this, Catacombs? Can't seem to kill the final monster, what a twist. There you go. Man, like, that's a thing. Like, in D&D and stuff, too, nobody ever looks up. I did not mean to do that. Apparently hitting shift fire is your alt fire. Nobody ever looks up. Alright. Come on, jerk face the destroyer. Hey. Sunlight is supposed to be your... Ah, fuck. The sunlight is supposed to be your anathema. I think that killed him, though. I think I saw his gibbs exploding over the edge there at the end of that. Oh, my God. You guys, I swear I'm only bad at video games on the internet. Okay. Let's see if we can't. Oh, why would I do that? Oh my God. Jesus Christ. I didn't jump there, okay? I didn't. I know I jump a lot. I tend to jump around on occasion. That was not me. That was the game's physics screwing me. Alright. Against my... Let's try and... Come on. See if I can maybe... Oh, there we go. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, no. Oh, there we go. Alright. Easy! Never a doubt in my mind. I totally knew what I was doing the entire time. Hey, we got another card, nice. The Soul Keeper, souls stay longer. Let us see. I am four short. I would use that too. So I guess next time we will get that. But for now, I'm gonna call it. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time and I will see you all next time when the violence continues. Until then.